Today, Bhavya Narasimha Murthy joined me to discuss
what is happening in Congress in Karnataka. Ma'am, how are you?
I'm good, sir. Thanks for having me here.
Thank you, ma'am. Ma'am, nowadays petrol price is going very high and it reached more than 100 rupees. And we are able to see that too much activities happening within a Congress. So what all you people are having planned in future about the protest?
So for the past 4 days, Congress has been protesting in every petrol bunk across the state. In fact, one day it was at the state level, then at a district level, then it was in taluk level, then Hobli level, until Gram Panchayat. I think today it was Gram Panchayat or Hobli level. So every around 5,000 petrol bunks, Congress workers and Congress leaders have been protesting against the price hike, how the petrol and diesel have reached 100 rupees now. In fact, both petrol and diesel have come to the same cost. And LPG, which was once 400 rupees when Congress was in power, is 1,000 rupees today. So we are protesting all these price hike. We want to bring about this awareness in people that at one point when each barrel costed more during Congress rule, the petrol price was 60, 70 between this thing. And now the cost has reduced. Crude oil price has reduced and still people are paying 100 rupees per liter. By saying this, I want to also mention that for every 100 rupees you are paying, 52 rupees goes to the center when it comes to petrol and 58 rupees goes to center when it comes to diesel. So you're only paying literally 48 rupees for the petrol you're getting. Everything else you're paying is going to the as a tax. One. And if you remember, BJP came to power using this very issue, saying the petrol price hike, diesel price hike during the Congress time, they protested against this. They promised the people that they will bring down the price and they came to power. They said, Achhe Din will be here where you won't have to pay this much. Even when it comes to the foreign exchange, like dollar, they said it will be $ 15 rupees per dollar. And today, you know, even the dollar cost has gone up. And I would also want to bring another issue here. Yeah, you were talking about what Congress has plans to do in future. Right now, protest is not just at the state level. Like I said, till Gram Panchayat, we are planning to do the protest and people are doing it every day because of the lockdown. Our president had kept a time gap, that is between 9 to 10. Anyone who is protesting, we are supposed to get on this Zoom call, which the president, CLP leader, all our Congress leaders can watch directly as to where all the protests are happening and how many people are protesting, how many petrol bunks, in how many petrol bunks we are protesting. So we are trying to take this protest to the people, to their doorstep, as much as possible. And because of the lockdown, we have been told like very less people, but protest. Maintain all the guidelines, corona guidelines, but protest.
So see, you are telling about like BJP also came power with the making this type of issue in 2013, right? And if you see that time that situation was not very bad about the petrol price, but they make very noise and entire media was talking about all this thing. But if you see that the same thing is missing with the Congress, when real problems are there and petrol price has gone very high, you people don't seem to like active like a BJP.
So the problem is not that Congress is not protesting or Congress is not doing anything. So the problem here is how much media coverage are we getting? I just told you, we are protesting at Gram Panchayat level. We have been protesting for 1 hour every day in various petrol bunks, around 5,000 petrol bunks across the state. But this has not been reported by the media. That's why people are not coming to know about this. They're not being aware of this. The way media was unbiased at one point of time, we all know it's an open secret that most of the media houses are not unbiased today. They're all biased and they don't really cover what the opposition is doing. We have been protesting. We have protested every issue.
Correct.
whether it was a farmers issue, whether it was the anti-CAA movements, or whether it was the recent farmers issue, like I said, or this corona corruption issue, and online, offline, we did online campaigns, we did offline, we were the one who started this universal vaccine for all these campaigns, we were the one who started, and then the prime minister announced.
So,
but the problem is the media coverage that we are getting. Media is being very biased, most of them at least, and we are not getting enough media coverage. If only we had unbiased media, and as you know, most of the independent institutions of our country, which have constitutional positions, most of them have been biased these days, including Election Commission.
But you see that this will be the failure of Congress, because the Modi government came only on 2014. Okay, from that always Congress was there in power. So within a 6 to 7 years time, they capture entire media and Congress fail. And even though if you see the social media, Congress not very active.
So for you to call this as Congress failure, I would not agree, because Modi government came. Congress was always democratic. When Congress was in power, we didn't instill fear in people who protested. People protested against the government. There was an anti-corruption movement that happened, because of which even a political party came up. But all those, even those camps turned out to be a fake. But still, Congress government was always democratic. People were not scared of protesting. People were not scared of raising their voice. Activists were not arrested. They were not put UAPA on each and every activist, and even students. They're scared of students, cartoonists, activists. BJP government is scared of everyone. They keep arresting anyone who talks against them. And then court has to come to their rescue. The court has to say they have a right to protest. You can't just arrest them. By the time they would have arrested and set an example so that no one else will speak against them. And then they get released. They don't even get bail these days, as you know. Even recently, cartoonists were arrested. When you set such a precedent, BJP government is not being democratic. This is not Congress's failure. Congress has always kept this country in a democratic manner, whether a person is against the government or for the government. The Congress government previously, a lot of even the Nirbhaya case, the way the whole country protested the government when the Nirbhaya case happened, what did the Congress do? They amended the rape laws. They brought strict punishment for the rarest of the rare cases. They amended the rape laws. But what happened when Hathras rape case happened? What happened in UP when a BJP MLA raped a girl? They didn't take any action until the Supreme Court intervened and said, how can you have a rapist in your own party? And Supreme Court asked them to take him out of the party. Till then, the BJP didn't do that. BJP is not committed to any of the issues that really matter, whether it is women safety or anything else for that matter. And speaking about this recently, just because I am vocal about these issues, because I spoke about mishandling when it comes to corona, lockdown mishandling, or even the whole pandemic, or even the vaccination, how the shortage of vaccination is affecting the people of India. I spoke about this and I started getting threatening calls.
Okay.
It's been, today is the fifth day since it started, and it hasn't still stopped. Sixth day, today is the sixth day, and I have complained to the police. I even did a press conference about it. This is how they want to instill fear in people. Congress didn't do that, sir. It has nothing to do with Congress. It is about people who voted for BJP. Most of them voted thinking they will bring some change that they promised. They just turned out to be...
Yeah,
they just turned out to be very dictatorial in their administration.
So tell me one thing, you see, you are politically connected and you are with the Congress and all. And if you talk something truth, and then if you start getting the threatening call, what will happen to common man? What common man has to do at this point of time?
Exactly, sir. Exactly why I thought this should not go. I could have ignored these calls. It's not like I'm scared of these cowards. They have hacked my Facebook page before. They have commented in a very regressive manner, or I don't even know what kind of words to use for that. the comments I used to get, threat I used to get on social media, I used to ignore those. But this, they've gone one level, further and started calling me on my phone. And from 80 different numbers, registered across the country. Then I thought about it. Like, if this is the case to a woman like me, who just want to express my opinion, and everything I express, everything I say, I back it up with facts. It's not like I'm just coming and making statements here. And still I have to, if I have to face this, what about other women who don't have a backing, who don't have a backing of a political party, who don't have a backing from their family, but they want to be vocal? What about them? If someone scares them, if someone threatens them, if someone uses slurs, calls them and scares them, they might stop expressing themselves. So I thought my case should set an example. And I'm not going to stop until this season end, because so far the police, there is no progress. It's been, today is the sixth day since I gave the complaint. And so far there is no progress about it. And today I'm planning to meet the commissioner about this. And I'm not going to stop until the person, whoever is doing this, and everyone who is behind this, is behind bars. I'm not going to stop. And this I'm doing for the common people. This is for other women, every other woman, or any other person who wants to express their opinion without any fear. It is our fundamental right. This case is our right to express. It is our right to, about our right to dignity and about our right to safety. All three of our fundamental rights. My case is a classic example of this violation of my fundamental rights.
So what is the solution you see? What is the future of India?
So India's future is always with its people. People need to come out. We have to speak. If we have to secure our future, if we don't want our country to turn undemocratic or dictatorial, we need to come out. We need to speak up. We need to put our foot down and say, this country, for the past 70 years, whatever it is, will remain the same. It was democratic and it will remain democratic. Whatever is happening now, I would like to bring up, share one of my very memorable instances with H.S. Doraiswamy, sir, the former freedom fighter who expired recently. Once we were speaking, like, I used to visit him often to just check on him, how he's doing, because he's a very impressive personality. For his age, the passion he carried, it always inspired me. So I used to meet him once in a while. Once while talking, I was just saying, what is happening here, sir? What to do with this? What about our future? I asked the same question. He said, this is just a normal disturbance. We will pass this. Our country is too strong to get bowed down to such, ideology, such regressive ideology. Our country is not built based on this ideology. So we will survive this. It's just a passing time. But you should not stop. You should always fight. And you should make sure that our country's value is restored. That's what he used to say every time. And he was never without hope. He always said, I have complete hopes. Things will turn out to be how it was before, democratic and happy. Country will be happy again. That's what he used to say.
So one more thing, Alta. You spoke about that media is biased and they are definitely not covering your Congress party activity. But if you see other hand, you people are very weak on social media also. Why this thing is happening?
So I didn't say all media. Most of them don't cover Congress protests. But some of them do cover. I don't deny that. But what I tried to say was, when Congress was in power, media was always unbiased. It went against the government. It showed both the positives and negatives of the government. But as of now, no matter how much the government is failing in handling these situations, government is only being praised. Media is here to keep a check on the ruling government. Instead, they keep, most of them keep abusing the opposition.
No, what I'm trying to tell you, what is there your hand in the social media? There also, if you see...
social media presence.
You are very weak.
I'm answering that. Yeah. As you know, BJP has its own IT cell. They invest a lot in that. But Congress, as an IT cell in the sense where they actually spread fake news. They infuse fake news. Congress is not something, it is not in our ideology. It is not in the values we have been taught in our country as a country to spread fake news just to be in power. And the fake news factory is really strong with BJP. It's not like BJP IT cell is, BJP social media is strong. Just this fake news factory is strong. They push every news in WhatsApp. They have a good reach, I don't deny. But we, Congress, I think we are strong on social media. Most of us are there on social media. We are talking against the government. But like I said, my own example, whenever a person comes, they scare them. They use all these kind of cheap tricks to just instill fear in us so that we don't talk.
If you compare like one MLA versus another MLA, BJP versus Congress, if you see the social media of BJP, their Facebook, their YouTube channel, their LinkedIn, and their Twitter, it is always with the information. And the same level of, if you take about the number from the MLA for Congress, and you people not able to compare it. That see, I'm not talking about the fake news, but if you see the page wise, MLA versus MLA, you people are really very weak on the social media. Where you can improve, I don't think why Congress is always fail in this type of, because if you don't communicate with the public, how they will know what you all are doing?
Yes, there are two things here. What you're saying, social media definitely plays a big role. But India, whatever the Facebook has the highest reach, Twitter has some more, Instagram has another very big number, maybe in crores they are. They definitely are very around 400 million, that is around 40 crore people. Definitely, these people have a good reach. BJP has a good reach, but just because they have good reach and others don't have, or Congress, as per what you are saying, because I have seen people having millions of reach. If you see Rahul Gandhi's tweets and Narendra Modi's tweets, both of them have millions of followers. Narendra Modi has one of the highest, he comes among the topmost number of followers. But when it comes to the reach of these Twitter tweets, right? If you calculate the average, say take a week and then calculate the average number of reach or the retweets or the likes that Rahul Gandhi has with Narendra Modi, you will see that Rahul Gandhi's tweets reaches more people, is more liked by people than Narendra Modi, although he has a lot of followers. So it's not about how many people are there. It's about how many people really like you.
No, see, that
people will even follow. People that, follow everybody. Yeah, they follow that, comedians, they follow artists, they follow everyone. But how much they like them depends on what they tweet and how much that has been shared. Just compare Rahul Gandhi's tweets with Narendra Modi's tweets. You can easily say reach of Rahul Gandhi's tweet is more than Narendra Modi on an average. If you calculate any week, just take the past 1 week.
What you're talking about now, definitely if you compare last from 1 year, Rahul Gandhi's reach is going more. But if you see beyond, before when Narendra Modi fan club was very, very, people used to like him and people used to believe him, that time Rahul Gandhi's reach was very less. So when Rahul Gandhi page is active and he is posting regularly, why not other minister and down the line people are doing the same thing? That is my question.
So it's left to individual ministers and the MLAs. So I can't really comment on that. But most of them definitely have a good reach. Even our Karnataka ministers, ex-ministers from Congress, most of them do have a CLP, or our CLP is very active on Twitter as well.
What is the future of young generation in Congress, and after 2-3 years, where you are going to see?
So these days I see a lot of youngsters joining Congress. I joined Congress around 2 years ago, and so far, thankfully, my leaders have definitely, I don't have any political background. I came here all by myself. But my leaders, starting from Sushmita ma'am, Sushmita Dev, the All India Mahila Congress president, to D.K. Shivakumar sir or Siddaramaiah sir, they have identified the talent. They have been promoting, you know, people who are passionate about their work, who are passionate about politics. And they have made me the state level spokesperson. And I'm also the coordinator for Priyadarshini. In 2 years, I got a state level position. Like I started at a state level position. So I think the trend is changing, and more youngsters, if you see, even in Karnataka, we have a lot of capable, talented, passionate youngsters in Congress who will be future leaders. I can definitely say about that. Because you spoke more about social media, I would like to say, do not believe everything that you get on WhatsApp or you know, what you see on YouTube or anything like that. Please rely on the information you get from authentic sources like news channels, newspapers, who give you authentic information. Follow Press Bureau of India. I mean, this is where you need to see the news. Whatever people now, people can Photoshop, they can morph, they can do anything and change the whole narrative. So that is one thing I want to send out to people. The two, if you stop voicing your opinions today just because you're scared or someone scared you, our country will be a disaster in some years if we don't speak up and if we are scared of these things. This is the time we have to secure our country back and leave it to the future generation the way it was given to us as a democracy, as a country which was developing based on economy and not a country which was divided on the basis of religion. So I think it's very important for every one of us to sit and think through the narratives that have been floated and the fake news, because of which, I mean, some fake news have led to even, you know, people being killed. Whether it is the communal fake news or anything for that matter, like, this is something we all got to be very careful about. Yeah. And do not go by religion or the communal. Of course, the way the current narrative or the BJP party is floating, the communal narrative, people will get attracted to it because they're instilling a kind of fear anywhere in the world. When it comes to right wing, what they do is they instill fear in the majority, saying the minorities are here to hurt you. And that is how they gather the support of the majority. It might be Hindus and Muslims here. In US, the white supremacists do that with black people. And the same thing happened in Germany, where Hitler's army, the Nazi, killed lakhs of, you know, Jews. So this is what we need to stop. Like, when someone comes to divide us, stand together. Tell them we have been together for this many years and we will stay together. And there is no need to fear.
Thank you so much, Bhavya, joining me and giving all the brief.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.